Hey friends, my name's Duke. Welcome to Fallout 4. This will be a little different than the kind of game I normally play on the channel. This is a brand new, big budget, blockbuster release. I know I don't play many of those for YouTube, but Fallout is kind of the only big budget AAA series I really care about. I love Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas. And of course, this is a day one purchase for me, and I thought I would record my experience with it. Since this is a blind playthrough, I probably won't be doing as much of the yammering that I'm known for. It'll probably be me kind of just experiencing this game naturally. I will commentate when I have something to say, but it probably won't be the stream of consciousness, verbal waterfall that I'm normally known for in these kinds of videos. So if that's the kind of thing you're interested in, then watch on. If not, then I will of course get back to Castle in the Darkness and Shadowrun and all those other games I have on the back burner. But for now, let's experience some Fallout 4. I will start a new game. I am running this off of an SSD, so hopefully the load times won't be too bad. I wish subtitles were on. I'll be quiet.
In 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen.
FMV? Really?
He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima. Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Alright. That was three War Never Changes in what? Under a minute? Alright, so I guess this is where I choose my character. So I have read a little bit of, you know, the reviews floating around out there, and I watched the trailers and everything. That's all I know about this game. So from what I understand, the...
Hey, my turn, big guy.
Which one of these I choose is my player character through the game, and I can customize their faces and everything, and like it'll combine their features to generate our son, and our son is a character in the game as well, I think, from what I hear. Whoa! This guy seems pretty nonplussed. Or no, nonplussed means disturbed. He seems non-nonplussed. He seems plussed at his wife kind of shape-shifting in front of him. Huh. Oh, I see. A and D to cycle. I was cycling backwards. Well, I wish there was like a randomized key or something. Whoa. Huh. That seems robust. How did I have her hair highlighted a second ago? Did I just click on it? I don't have a mouse wheel, so I can't do whatever this action is. Can I use page up and page down? No. Okay, well, let's cancel that. Whoa. Oh, I see. So, I can change her hairstyle independently. Interesting. So, I escape out of that. Hit C to change the color. Okay. Cool. Well, I'm not going to go too crazy here. I never cared that much about character customization and stuff. I'll probably just use one of the presets, whichever preset looks, I don't know, most aesthetically interesting. I don't want to be like some stuffy 50s style housewife. I don't know, I kind of like the default. She looks like she means business. This is also pretty good. Don't like this hairstyle at all. You know what? Let's be as boring as possible.
Let me just slide
and just go with the default character for both of them. Well, let's see what my options are with the guy. Whoa, that guy looks like a dirtbag. You have the Nathan Drake option here. Like this dude's hair. Whoa, why is he so old? There's no old lady option. Maybe he's not old, maybe he's just prematurely gray. I'll probably go prematurely gray, so I shouldn't say anything. Yeah, let's just stick with these. Why not? Well, let's see what my options... Okay. So it's just like a slider here where you can... Okay. Yes, I will just go with the defaults, because why not? It's not like I'll actually see my character over the course of the game. And in a way, it seems like they might... I don't know. Put the most detail and attention into the default characters, because that's what presumably most people will be seeing throughout the game. I don't know. Maybe not. Oh wait, actually, I wanted to be the lady. Can I switch again? I don't guess I can.
Huh?
Maybe I have to talk to her?
Hurrying up. Don't worry.
Okay. Well, that's annoying. Alright, well, let's just, Oh, this is my little test video where I was running around checking the frame rate and stuff. Let's just delete that. This is probably... I don't know what the save is. Very Skyrim-style loading screen there. Okay, now I'm the lady.
Hun?
I didn't change any of the defaults in my little test thing either, so...
Ah, good morning, Mom. Your clock is 173.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection. And today's newspaper just delivered.
Thanks, Codsworth.
Of course, Mom.
All right, let's see if I can turn on some general subtitles here. Dialogue subtitles on, general subtitles on. Okay.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies.
I want more coffee. Let me drink coffee.
We were nervous at first, but I'm glad we got Codsworth.
You know, after seeing the way the robot handled the birthday cake in Fallout 3, I don't know if I'd trust one of those things with a child, with a living human being.
Nuka-Cola. Ice cold.
Some good-looking bottles.
Looks like the milk got delivered. Saddle up Salisbury steak. Rated A+.
It's weird that my character is talking. That's a...
salesman again. I don't know why he keeps bothering you.
How can someone so small drink so much?
That's a new development for this game. There's a salesman at the door. It's just... let him.
More of the same.
Oh, hey, we're in Boston. Cool.
Good old U.S. of A.
He's persistent. Give him that.
A lot of late nights. It was worth it.
Whoa, I'm a doctor? Or I guess I'm a law doctor? A lockter?
Never gonna find that dog.
Well, no, I want to find the dog.
Maybe if we ignore him, he'll go away.
Well, mirrors still don't work. Something that has not improved from the previous games.
Another foreign product of General Atomics International. Let Codsworth take care of it.
Hopefully he's not in there killing my baby.
I'm kind of impressed.
We really need to get those vacation photos developed. No need to get dressed twice. I'm so proud of him.
Oh, so I guess the narrator in the intro there would be my husband. Looks like I wasn't the one who was actually in the army.
Well, now I just want to know who's going to give up first, us or him.
Why don't you answer the dang door, dude?
Hey, hon.
Can you get the door? Whenever I answer, he just asks for you over and over.
Now who left those here? It's a little early to be drinking.
Well, now I just want to know who's going to give up first, us or him. And now look at sports. Something that is unquestionable, inescapable, and never to still there. I'm kind of impressed.
All right, what do you want?
Good morning, Vault-Tec calling.
Oh, so I have 4 dialogue options here that seem to be mapped to... Isn't that going to be the arrow keys, or can I use WASD? Not interested, dude. No, I can't use WASD, okay? That's going to be annoying. Not interested.
No offense, but...
Wait,
no solicitor.
I don't want that character.
Oh, no worries, ma'am. No worries at all. I'm not selling anything. Not today. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
All right, let's bounce out of here real quick and redo this. Redo my character here. I know it's not that important, but... I'm a little... A little interested in how my character looks, I guess. Alright, let's just skip this.
War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Alright, good old Mr. and Mrs. Default American.
Hey, my turn, big guy.
Yes, I will confirm this character. I put a lot of work into her. Whoa. Oh, weird.
Ah, good morning, Mom.
Thanks, Codsworth.
Of course, Mom.
So I took the coffee pot, but what did I do with it? There's already a cup of coffee here. Alright, let's look at my baby before I talk to that guy. That's one thing I didn't do.
Wonder what Sean will grow up to be.
Oh, I don't get to name my baby? Lame. It's the weird spelling of Sean, too. All the Seans I ever knew spelled their name S-E-A-N. Well, they didn't spell their name that way. That's just how their name was spelled. Hey. Chill out, guy.
I know we were nervous at first, but I'm glad we got Codsworth.
Hey, I'm a pretty good parent. Alright, I'm keeping my eye on you, Codsworth.
Hey, Codsworth.
Enjoy your coffee, Mom.
Oh, thank you. Alright, do you say anything before the salesman shows up?
Hey, hon.
Do I look nervous? I look nervous, don't I? It's that salesman again. I don't know why he keeps bothering you.
Are my subtitles still on? They might not be since I... Yeah, they're still on. They just weren't showing up there for some reason. Alright, a little bit of glitchiness off the bat, which... You know, you expect with the Bethesda game. Hopefully... The glitchiness is not overwhelming. I haven't watched any, like, actual gameplay footage of this or anything yet. I wanted to go into it completely blind.
Late nights. It was worth it.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Yes? Okay. Let's go with my choice from before. Not interested.
No offense, but no soliciting.
Oh, no worries, ma'am. No worries at all. I'm not selling anything. Not today. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Urgency?
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, ma'am, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think. if you catch my meaning. Now I know you're a busy woman, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being, a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
Very Mass Effect-y kind of dialogue system. I like the dialogue in Mass Effect. I like how the system worked. I just hope that... Well, I mean, I guess I'm just going to have four dialogue options every time, which is kind of weird. Can I just click on these? Yeah, I can.
Are you feeling all right, ma'am?
Let's be sarcastic. Nuclear war? Ha! Like, that's ever going to happen.
The apocalypse? Well, hell, sign me up.
That's the spirit.
I wasn't very sarcastic.
Now, let's see.
Or maybe he just misinterpreted me. Oh, okay. Here we go. Character creation. Alright. So I do know a little bit about how the leveling and stuff works in this game. I know that they did away with skills and that there are just perks associated with each of these attributes now. So let's see. With 21, that would allow me to put 3 into each of these. So that would give me a base stat level of 4 for everything. Which the way the previous Fallout games work is I think they start you out with a base level, a base of 5 in every stat, and you can reduce some stats to add points to others. And I think there were actually a few, they gave you a few points to put into stats to raise them above 5. So you could have like 6 or 7 in a couple stats and leave the rest of them at 5 if you wanted to. Or you could reduce some of your stats down to 1 and have plenty of points to put into other abilities. Now I'm assuming, from what I've heard, it's actually a lot easier to increase these stats over the course of the game in Fallout 4. Which I guess that's why they start you out at a base of 4 in each stat and won't let you, or if you start with a base of 4, you can't increase any of them above 4. Because you'll be increasing the stats over the course of the game, which makes sense. Now, what kind of character do I want to play? I like a lot of dialogue options in games like these, so I'm going to start with a pretty high charisma. Say a 7, and affects the number of experience points earned, okay? I like being sneaky. I'm going to give myself a pretty high agility here. So that gives me 9 points. I like being perceptive. By the way, I'm just playing on normal. I might change that over the course of the game if normal proves to be too easy. But I play most games on normal. So let's give me a 4 there. Do I want any points in strength? How much you can carry? That would be helpful. I'm not planning on doing much melee in this game. I'd rather have a good intelligence, though. Mental acuity. Intelligence affects stuff like hacking and ability to like use machines and stuff like that. I never put any points into luck, usually. The recharge rate of critical hits. Interesting. So I wonder if that means luck would actually have kind of a tangible, visible effect. If so, I might regret only leaving 1 point in luck. But I can always increase it later, I assume. Let's give me some endurance. Maybe 7 in charisma is overkill. Let's... Some tough decisions when you don't have that many points. That's 5 intelligence should be, I mean, that's average. So that gives me 2 points to put into something. And I'm not going to worry about strength. It's not the way I roll. Alright, let's start with average, charisma, and perception. and put a few more points into endurance. There we go. Have a 6 in agility and charisma. I want to be a smooth talker and I want to be sneaky. Those are the two most important attributes to me. Alright. I am accepting this. So, R. Oh, character. Wait. Name your character. Okay. Forgot about that. Well, since I'm a lady, obviously...
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that maternal affection you seem to be so good at.
Go ahead, honey. I'll be there in a second to help, okay?
Alright, time to work my magic again.
My boy isn't giving his mother any trouble, is he? Hey, I fixed that mobile in his crib the other day. Why don't you give it a spin?
Way ahead of you, dude. Oh, I guess I didn't do that in the save, though.
That's my boy. On his best behavior, just like his dad.
Or maybe I did.
Well, most of the time, anyway. Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Halloween prep? Huh. I wonder if they put that in because they knew that this game was going to come out right after Halloween. Or not right after Halloween, but shortly after Halloween.
Let's get pumpkins instead. Carve jack-o'-lanterns.
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Don't know who closed the door on us. Codsworth.
Followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation. We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations.
Oh no.
We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
God. We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean. Let's go!
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate Vault 111 immediately.
Keep it on, hold on, participants. Let's hold on.
Who cares?
Just help me pack it up.
You don't get in.
I'm going in. You can't stop me.
Oh, hey, it's a salesman.
Okay. I'm reporting this.
If you're in the program, step forward. Otherwise, return home.
Excuse me.
Are you registered
or not? Not in the vault program.
My God, we're gonna die.
Excuse me.
We're gonna die out here.
Hey,
if you're not registered, you're not getting in.
Hey!
Are you registered?
Why, yes, I am registered.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant? Adult male? Adult female? Okay,
it.
Go ahead.
Wow, not even asking my name, huh?
You two, follow me! Come on! What's gonna happen to all those people outside
We're
the
doing
gate?
Everything
this
we
way!
Can.
Now keep
hey.
Moving! Keep going! This way!
On the platform, in the center!
Alright, that's it! Send it down!
Almost there! Is Sean okay?
He's fine. We're gonna be okay. I love you.
Oh my God!
Hold on!
Can't this thing move faster?
Oh God!
We're okay.
Everyone, please, step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No, no.
We'd all be.
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
Hey, hon.
It's gonna be okay, right?
Well, this way.
Hey.
Up the stairs.
Excuse me.
Welcome to your new home. Up the stairs, please.
What's going on? Hey.
We just need a minute.
Please, keep moving. Up the stairs and through the door.
For you. All new residents, please proceed in an orderly fashion.
Female.
Welcome home.
Male and infant.
Hey there. Oh my God.
Weird, no one wants to talk.
Hey.
Just step over to the table.
Looks fine.
One vault, Sam. Now just head down the hall.
Excuse me.
Move along.
Hey.
Nothing to see here.
Running some scans, all very routine.
Nothing to see here? I disagree.
Hey.
Hello there. Once we seal the vault, we'll all be getting to know each other a lot more, I'm sure.
Everything okay?
We made it.
Keep moving.
Welcome to Vault 111.
Take one of these.
I'm sure
your
you'll
brand
feel
new
right
vault
at home.
Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
It's down the hallway right there.
See? This is our new home.
Hey,
oh, you're gonna love
down
it.
That hallway.
This
they'll
is
show
one
you
of
where
our
to
most
go.
Advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
My mother and father down in D.C.
Excuse me.
Oh God, honey.
Move along.
What if they didn't make it? I know this is a
How long do you think
time.
We'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
As well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Looks very homey.
Excuse
me.
Just step into the chamber.
It'll be okay. Mommy's right here. See?
I didn't know I was contaminated.
Will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3.
Cryogenic what?
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
Everything's gonna be fine.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Jesus Christ. Well, I'm sure they'll unthaw him once they discover a cure for a gunshot wound to the heart. Always read the fine print whenever you're offered a free stay in a Fallout vault. That's one lesson I have learned well from the previous Fallout games. Alright, so I have a quest. Exit Vault 111. Alright, I have my normal movement speed back, which is nice. I can sprint. I can punch. Still don't have a Pip-Boy, so I can't check my stats or inventory or anything.
Come on. There has to be a release.
You mean the big knob labeled pressure release here? Is that the release? Oh, here we go.
Come on, come on, come on. I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
And took his wedding ring. It's a nice little detail. Hey, I'm armed. Nice. I'm sure my 1 point in strength will come in handy. Oh, hey. The contents of the file cabinet just kind of pops up there. Alright, let's take some money. Can I... So I guess if I take... I have to take, oh okay, so I can just hit R and I can choose what items I want to take if I don't want to take everything. Now I do know, oh. I do know that there is an in-depth crafting system in this game, and random junk you find in the world will be important for crafting items and stuff. I don't know if a battery clipboard will be helpful or not. I will take the cigarette, though, because I am going to want to hit escape to get out of this every single time. So tab to exit. Okay. Can I use this yet? Nice, I can. See? Always read the fine print. Okay, that's the same. Same message that was in the instructions here. Wait. Did I read the security logs? No. Okay, here we go. Yeah, would have been nice. Oh, so there is a mutiny. Wonder what load holotape does. Oh, I have none. Okay. Oh, that was informative. I'll take a stim pack. I will take a cigarette carton. And, oh, so there is no take all. You just have to hit E on each item you want to take. Cartons of cigarettes are very valuable in the post-apocalypse. Alright, anything else to look at before I go in the quest direction? I'll take some tools. I bet those will be useful. Man, everything already kinda looks post-apocalyptic in here. Wonder how long it's been. Inaccessible. We'll see about that. Oh, deregulate temperature. That's probably bad. Roach meat, eh?
Giant roaches.
I think I'll leave that where it is for now. Oh yeah, I remember this from the trailer. There's like retro style games you can play in Fallout. Start game. That is straight out of Donkey Kong. That's awesome. Can I go down? Nope. Whoa, you're throwing nukes at me? That's not cool. Donkey Kong never threw nukes. I mean, maybe. I don't know what was in those barrels. The power-up is a power armor helmet. That's kind of cool. See if I can actually get there. Oh, you can't climb? What, when you, well, that's what would be kind of, oops. Kind of hard to climb in that armor. I gotta at least beat the first level with this. So what's the point of the, oh, come on, of the armor if I can't even climb in it? That's kind of lame. Yes, I'll play again. Looks like I'll be able to take this game with me. That's pretty cool. I love stuff like this. This is a really cool addition. I mean, it's cheesy and unnecessary, but it makes me smile. Can I shoot? No? Unless there's a different button that shoots. Nope, guess not. I would totally be playing this game in this situation, by the way. Thawed out after X number of years in cryostasis, alone in this terrifying, dangerous environment. Let's play some video games. Oh, he even has a Vault 111 jumpsuit. That's nice. It's a customized version of Red Menace, specifically for this vault. Unless someone programmed this during the course of the stay in the vault. Which, I mean, I guess there's not much else to do when you're in a vault. Might as well learn programming. Whoa! I wasn't expecting the direction of the platform to reverse. I armored right over that circle. Hey, I got the high score. I have to start from the beginning, right? Yeah. Alright, that's enough. Yeah, I'll quit. Did I make the top 10? No. Bummer. Alright, let's take that with us. It is kind of nice not having to go into a menu every time you want to loot a container. I guess not having a take all button isn't that big a deal. Nothing in the fridge. I'm carrying 8 out of 210. I guess I'm assuming that's pounds and not items. Oh, there's my wedding rings. Oops. Can I equip it from here? Yeah? No? Just transfer. I have zero bottle caps. That is, I wonder what the heart next to it means. I guess that means it's a good item. Oh, and there's my video game cartridge. Nice. Hey, it's worth 300. That's pretty good. There I go again. I'm going to hit escape for a long time until I remember I need to hit tab to back out of that menu. That looks dangerous. Mouse 2 to block. Sure, I'll take some rad roach meat. It might come in handy. I guess. I don't know. Press the left alt to power attack. I see. So you can't just hold down the attack button to power attack. That's how it always was in the previous Fallout games. Hey! Lots of stim packs. Can be favorited for quick use. Oh, maybe that's what the heart means. Maybe that means it's a favorite item. It's like on my hotbar or something. Bobby pins are important for lockpicking. Nice.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
She's unfrozen for 10 minutes and already she's a gun freak. That's awesome. There's some ammo there. It's going to be hard to untrain myself because I'm used to just walking up to a container and immediately hitting E to see what's inside. But now, I can just see what's inside without pressing a button. I mean, I bet I would be pretty thirsty after being frozen for 1,000 years or however long it's been. I wonder why it puts my gun down when I look at this thing. I mean, it's not like... Or is that just because I'm looking down? No. Specifically when I'm looking... I guess it's just moving it out of the way so I can read that sign. That's kind of cool. Or maybe it's... Oh, it's whenever you walk up to a wall like that. I guess it assumes that if you're right up next to a wall, it's because you want to see something on it.
Lock's really strong.
What, I'm not a master lockpicker right out of the gate? Boo.
Terminal should open this.
Terminal A. Ah, here we go. Right, this is similar to information on the previous terminal, as this is specifically the Overseer's terminal. You think this would be locked or something? I'm gonna start using the keyboard to control the terminal because the mouse interface is a little iffy. Plus it makes me feel like an elite hacker. Alright, I already looked at all that. Yeah, that's the same stuff from before. I believe that's talking about me. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. 180 days doesn't seem like nearly enough time. Oops, there's more to that. Wonder if I can load Red Menace on this computer and play here. No, I guess not. This doesn't have the load holotape option.
Don't think I can pick this.
I was hoping there would be an option on the terminal to unlock the cryo later, but it was just a diary entry about it. Lame. Man, I don't like games where you have to aim down sights. Like, I always prefer having a crosshair. You know, something I can say with confidence is where I'm aiming, because I'm never sure. Probably shouldn't be wasting ammo on these things, but I don't think it'll give me an option. What? I didn't want to do that. I don't understand why it used a stim pack there. I pressed 1 just to try to switch back to my baton. Oh, there. Okay. The baton is 3. And the pistol is 4. I'm assuming that once I have the ability to go into my inventory, I can actually assign hotkeys the way I want. Maybe I chose the hotkey for the stim pack by mistake. Maybe that was set to 1 or something. But you think it would indicate that somewhere. It does make it a little sound effect when I press 1, so maybe that's what happened. So I'm assuming there won't be any actual humans down here. So I probably won't need to make use of my gun, really. Wait, it was saying how to sneak. To perform melee attacks while wielding a gun, press left alt. Okay, so I can have my gun out. Oh, just pistol whip people, I guess. So it was saying, it said something about caps lock there. I think it was talking about sneaking. Or is that just, okay, so when I press caps lock, I kind of slow to just a normal walk. So shift is sprint, which is a welcome addition to the game. Nothing doing with those skeletons. Hey! Oh, hey! Wait, what was the... How did I do this? What button did I push? I think I pressed... Oh, okay, so there's my hotkey. So 0 is stim pack, it looks like. 3 is my baton. 4 is my pistol. Not sure why that didn't... Okay, so alt is gun whip. Can I hold something to kind of spin my view around here? Get a look at myself? I guess not. So control is crouch, which is also the sneak. Can I sprint while sneaking? No. That wouldn't make much sense, would it? Alright, what button did I push to go into first person? Was that... Or third person? Wait, okay, so I pressed something and it brought up a little inventory wheel. Okay, so V is change view. I guess it didn't change view before because I had that little inventory wheel up. So what button was that? Okay, so X is auto walk. Okay, so F brings that up. Can I only have 4 shortcuts? That would be disappointing. Because in the old Fallout games, you could use all of the number keys for shortcuts. It wasn't very intuitive. You kind of had to figure it out for yourself. But once you realized it, it was very handy. I love shit like this. Imitating old computer boot up screens. It's the best. Alright. Got my Pip-Boy. So... okay, so you can zoom in here. That's cool. So Q to favorite something. Oh, here we go. Okay, you do get 9 slots. Good. So I want my... I want my baton to be number 1. My gun to be number 2. And apparel. So I can only wear one of the wedding rings. Okay. Put on some glasses. They're probably not my prescription, but, you know, you gotta look smart in the post-apocalypse. Alright, this I want to make 0. Oh, I guess it was already 0. Okay, so. So I can eat this to gain 15 hit points. It's cool that it shows you the Raz effect everything has down there. I guess the old games did too, but... yes, I can play video games on my Pip-Boy. That is awesome. Does not look like the controls would be very good, though. I don't want to play Donkey Kong with a little wheel thing. I mean, I guess you would go for the power armor if you're trying to get a high score or something. What's the Red Menace supposed to be? Looks like... I don't know, a communist ghost, I guess. Its head looks kind of like a squid. Dang it. Oh, it still has my high score up there. That's awesome. Wonder how many of these video games there are. Because I'm going to play all of them. It's like a let's play within a let's play. Oh, I have to walk over each of these little... okay, that's very similar to a level in Donkey Kong. It's summoning mini ghosts now. Man, I have not played Donkey Kong in so long. Ha! Suck it, communism. And it just loops. But the level's different, that's cool. Oh, come on. I jumped over that. Man, my score is... tremendous. This level looks pretty similar to how it looked on the first loop. Man. $16,400, nice. I guess I can't see the top 10 list. That was specific to that computer. Can I inspect the tape? Hey! Oh, I guess that's supposed to be a racist caricature of a Chinese person. Because in this universe, China is the big communist antagonist. I mean, I guess they were for us as well, but they weren't quite at the level that the Soviet Union was. See? Cigarettes worth 50. Pre-war money. It's worth its weight in cloth, I guess. Hey, ammo doesn't have weight. That's nice to see. Oh, so here's my quest. Out of time. Exit Vault 111. I have that active. Some stats. Whoa. Huh. Okay. Not sure what the point of this is, but it's fun. Whee! I'm holding down mouse 2 to do this. Okay, so... Okay, so I can use WASD to kind of switch between the tabs here. Well, sort of. Okay, so W and S to go between the top tabs. A and D to go between the bottom tabs. So how do I kind of move around the map here? Arrow keys? No? Okay, I just drag with mouse 1. Can I zoom in and out with plus and minus? Page up and page down. I hope there will be a way for me to zoom out. I'll probably have to go into my controls and fiddle with some stuff there. So I guess this is the world map. So what's the local map? Okay. Okay. I can dig it. Perk chart. Whoa. This is kind of cool. I hope there are more perks than this. Oh, okay, so each one of these perks has multiple levels, so plus 10 damage resistance, plus 20, plus 30, okay. Requires level 46, wow. So from what I understand, there's really no level cap or anything, so theoretically, you can unlock everything in this game if you play it long enough. Man, a lot of weird stuff with the interface of this game. Like, why would you use Alt and Control to look at the other ranks? No radio stations yet. I guess that makes sense since I'm deep underground. That's cool. Has a little built-in Geiger counter right here. What am I getting extra? Oh, is that from my glasses? Yeah, perception plus 1. Cool. There I go again, hitting escape. Cycle damage. Oh, I guess there are different types of damage. It's like shock damage, radioactive damage. That might be physical damage. Huh. Alright, let's see if I can fix that. Change it to escape to back out. Well, if I do that, though, then escape won't be the menu key anymore. I mean, backing out of Pip-Boy makes sense because you hit tab to activate it. It's just the other menus where hitting tab doesn't make much sense. Do I have my Pip-Boy light still? Yep, there it is. A healthy green glow. Wonder if that's on a battery or anything in this one. Whoa, the screen was super bright. Oh, is that the light switch on top? Looks like it. I can't watch myself press the button. Okay, so there's my shortcut thing. Okay, cool. Oh, there we go. I guess you just need to not be moving. Just stand still and you can kind of circle around. Nice. Wonder if you can see the wedding ring on my finger. Yep, there it is. Now that is attention to detail. Alright. Let's do some stuff. Poor guy. Real lady. You can't really tell. Oh, it's another elevator. Weird. I mean, I guess having an elevator makes more sense than just kind of a big door in the side of a hill or something. Stand within circle. Well, how do you like this? Well, I guess I can't. Okay. So, as in the previous Fallout games, you have kind of a brief window where it's not really a tutorial, but it's kind of an introduction, and then you can change your appearance and stuff before you continue with the actual game. I'm good with where I am. It's not like I have much of a choice. It was Vault-Tec or death. And Vault-Tec very nearly turned into death. Alright. Well, I guess that's a good place to end this recording, so I will continue playing, and you can watch the continued exploits of Duchess in the next video. Goodbye.